everyone. So today I am shooting in the car at Sonic because earlier we had our bug guy come and spray our house like we do every couple of months. And I am really, really, really sensitive to the way that it smells and it makes me sick. So I leave the house for a little while to let that air, you know, settle or whatever so that I don't smell it anymore. It's interesting though, because one possible symptom with Lyme is increased senses, I guess you would say, like, or sensitivity to your senses. I don't know the best way to say it, but any sort of stimulation like that. Some people are really affected by it, and I am really affected by smells, so much that I smell things that aren't supposed to really have an odor. Like the spray that our bug guy uses isn't supposed to have any odor. It's supposed to be odorless. And my parents can't smell it, the guy can't smell it, but I can smell it. And it's so bad that it makes me sick to my stomach. It's just one of those things. But, you know, it's something to bring light to for other Lymies out there who are sensitive to smell. Some are sensitive to sight, like the bright lights bother them. Noise, I'm definitely sensitive to noise. I'm always turning music down. I don't like listening to loud things. If I'm at a place that's really loud, it really bothers me. This is a good example. One time I went to a volleyball tournament with a friend of mine, and there was like a gym full of different volleyball games going on all at the same time, and there was a lot of noise, like whistles being blown and people yelling and audience cheering, and it was just really loud. And I had to like go outside a bunch of times because it just gets to be too much for me, and it makes me feel really bad. It makes my dizziness worse. It just makes me feel sick in general. It's really weird, and I don't understand it. Since I was a kid, I've always been sensitive to noise, but not to this extreme. It's just something that's gotten worse with Lyme. It's strange, I know, but whatever. And then what are the, oh, taste? I don't really have that sensitivity to taste. That'd be interesting though. I wonder if other people dealing with Lyme have a sensitivity to taste, or what that would be like. And touch, it's a lot of people with fibromyalgia can relate to this. They say that just like the simplest touch causes pain, and that's because fibromyalgia is like sensitivity of nerves in your skin or whatever. Don't quote me on that because I'm not totally sure what fibromyalgia is, but it's something like that. But anyway, there are definitely times when just the lightest touch just is painful to me. So sensitivity to touch as well. But anyway, I thought that I could make a video about this because it is a problem with Lyme disease, and I think it's an interesting one. It's not the normal type of symptoms you hear about, so I thought I would bring light to it. I think the next video I'm going to be talking about the more neurological side of Lyme disease, because I feel like the neurological side of Lyme is a huge deal and I haven't really touched upon any of it, and part of that reason is because my neurological symptoms aren't as extreme as other neurological symptoms that are out there. So you can look forward to that this coming week. I don't know when I'll be able to record it. I have not been recording lately, but I will get back onto it. In the meantime, check out my other videos. I have just short videos about day-to-day things, and also some really cute videos of my nephews that are just super cute. Cute to me because they're my nephews, but I think that's about it. So thank you so much for watching, and sorry I'm in my car, but you know, you do what you gotta do. And I'm gonna give a shout out to Sonic. I really like their strawberry limeades. Okay, bye guys.